and that is Mike Tyson making Tyrell Biggs wait, and both fighters making the crowd wait, and they're starting to get the first glimpse now of Mike Tyson. And Tyson, we understand, is going to run into the ring. And here comes Mike Tyson now, and as usual, he is all business, draped in the three belts that he now owns.
Well, as Mills Lane, the referee from Nevada, says, Mike Tyson surely looks like he's saying, let's get it on.
He was telling us the other day that there's an expression on the streets where he was raised that say, you got to bring it to get it. And that's exactly his philosophy.
It means that you can't win at the tables with your hands in your pockets. And you can't win in here unless you take some shots, take some risks.
You know, he quotes Joe Frazier, actually, as he comes into the ring when people criticize his height, that he's too small. And he says Frazier believed he was big enough to get the job done, and that's all that counts. Mike Tyson, of course, 31-0, 27 knockouts.
Until he won the title, actually, he hadn't fought anybody more impressive than Biggs has fought to this point. Since that time, Tyson has fought a better class of fighter than Biggs has.
And the crowd, again, still very much into this. 5 years difference. Mike Tyson is younger than Biggs, even though he's had 31 fights to Biggs' 15.
Yeah, Barry, and Tyson, interestingly, came in a few pounds less than he has recently. Obviously, he wants to be able to keep up with the guy who's the boxer. And Biggs came in bulked up by a few pounds. Obviously, he wants to be strong for Tyson. What it means is they're both ready.
15 rounds for the undisputed heavyweight championship of the world. A referee for this bout is Tony Orlando. Introducing first, fighting out of the blue corner. He's wearing the white trunks and weighs 228¾ pounds. He's from Philadelphia, Pennsylvania. This Olympic gold medal champion has 15 consecutive victories, 10 by knockout. Introducing the number one challenger in the world, Tyrell Biggs. Fighting out of the red corner, wearing the solid black trunks, he weighs 216 pounds. From Catskill, New York, 27 of his 31 unblemished victories are by knockout. Ladies and gentlemen, the undefeated, undisputed, heavyweight champion of the world, Iron Mike Tyson!
Gentlemen, you received your instructions prior to coming to the ring. Therefore, I expect a good, clean bout. Do you have any questions? Touch gloves, back to you, corner. Good luck.
Barry and Ray, I wouldn't be surprised if this fight lasted a minute or an hour.
I feel exactly the same way. It's one of those fights you really don't know. I believe in the opinions of many of the people who feel that Tyrell Biggs can win the fight. I don't happen to be of that school, but you just don't know.
Expect Tyson to jump right on Tyrell Biggs.
Three questions that Mike Tyson really has to answer. Can he cope with a clever boxer? Can he survive a heavy puncher? And can he persevere when he's hurt?
You notice right from the start, Tyson is applying the pressure, trying to slow his man down. I'm seeing more jabs from Mike Tyson than I've seen in the past. I see a lot of movement on the part of Tyrell Biggs. Good lateral movement. Those hands should be up a little higher because, again, the hand speed of Mike Tyson is very good.
You have said that Biggs has to go side to side to win the fight, Ray.
Go side to side, give your man angles, throw the jab like he's doing now, not to let Tyson set up.
Now, Tyson also said that he has found a pattern in Tyrell Biggs, that he feints to the right before the punch actually is thrown.
Well, whatever he does, the fact that Tyson has to set up to get that kind of leverage. See, a good snapping jab is very effective. Whether or not Biggs can keep this up is yet to be seen. It's not time to be pretty in here. It's just time to frustrate this man. And that's what they want from our bigs. Good, consistent jab.
And along the lines of patterns, Biggs feels that Tyson actually bobs in a pattern four times, and then he comes up with his head.
See, wait, now here, you saw how Tyson walks in with that crouching style to deliver a shot. He's trying for the head. Now we see him head hunting from Mike Tyson. He can't get into that.
Good shot by Tyson.
Get off the ropes, tie your man up. That's the way. Get him back into the center ring. Use the jab again. And come with that right hand.
That was a quick little overhand right by Tyrell Biggs.
Biggs now is talking to Tyson. Again, Barry, he's trying to frustrate him. But I don't like his hands down that low. I don't like Biggs' hands down so low. Because Tyson throws those looping right hands and left hooks.
Keep him up, Mike. Keep him up.
Body shot by Tyson. Teofilo Stevenson, and I admit it was 5 years ago, but he really bothered
me. There is the hook. Again, because his hands are down. He's moving right, but he keeps his hands down too low. Tyson has very quick hands for a big man.
Stevenson beat Biggs by going to the body. Broke three ribs, as a matter of fact. A lot of water under the bridge since then. They're going to have to fix Tyson's equipment here in just a moment as it has come loose.
Biggs is starting to become a stationary target, which is wrong.
Right hand by Tyson. A little bit of blood inside the mouth of Tyrell Biggs.
I don't know if Biggs can fight a perfect fight, but he fought about as perfect a round as he could have hoped for to start this fight. There you see our punch stat, which tells you that Tyson's is not effective with the jab, and of course Tyrell Biggs is very effective with it.
Let it pull you around. Let it pull you around with two or four. Then stop.
And as Punchstat showed, or confirmed, that was a very good round using the left hand as well as he can. That is exactly what Biggs must do to stay in this fight. Can Tyson neutralize the jab?
You see, Biggs is doing great the first 2 minutes of the first round, keeping that jab consistent, moving lateral, giving angles, but then the last maybe 45 seconds of the round, Barry, he stopped, became stationary target. The hands again, which I think is a major mistake because of Tyson's hand speed. And Tyson throws his punch, he loops his right hand, he loops his hook, and Biggs could be asking for a few problems.
And the thing that strikes me actually is Biggs did have a round and did fight according to his fight plan, but he still took some strong shots from Tyson.
You see, now Biggs again, Barry, is starting to stand there and exchange toe-to-toe, like I said earlier. You can't do that. Tyson's punches come so fast with so much velocity behind them. It's devastating.
Biggs has shown a tendency, actually, throughout his career, and especially later in his career, most recently, to get in there occasionally and want to slug it out when he's been stunned. And that could be suicide.
And the way that Biggs is moving to his right, that's wrong because of the hook of Mike Tyson. He'll run right to the left hook.
Two hands, punch out. Let him go. All right, Frank, step out.
What I was expecting from Biggs, and in fact, they told me this, that he's prepared, working this in the gym, was the uppercuts, the jab, to go through Tyson's defense. I have not seen that yet.
And the game plan was for Biggs rather to move to his left. Now he's been moving to his right, and as you said, he's been getting himself a little trouble when he does so.
Tyson's driven some tremendous shots to the body, and that's going to help bring those hands down even lower.
Remember, Stevenson broke three ribs of Tyrell Biggs.
I'm looking for a left hook, Barry. I really am, because of, look at the right hand of Tyrell Biggs. That's the uppercut, but you got to come back with the right hand. The uppercut raises the chin of a guy who crouches in, and the right hand does the most damage.
There was a big right hand, best punch of the fight.
That was the left hook, Barry. That was the left hook I was talking about. Now, if Biggs should make it back to his corner, I'm sure Georgie Bennett will say, keep those hands high.
Right, left. I'll get it right.
Right, left, left. But the fact of the matter is, the right hand's down a bit. The left hook has been scoring. And it rocked Biggs.
As Michael Tyson said before this fight, everybody has a plan until they're hit.
A little bit more coming in, a little bit more jab. He started that round real good, then he slowed down with the jab. You heard me with that hook. You understand me? I want you to 5-1 now. 7-7 coming in. What's going to go 5-1? 5-5-1. You understand me? Take a little spring back and put a little twist in there. Take a little twist.
And here is Tyson's most effective punch. Biggs has been on his flat-footed more in this round than he was in the first round. Got nailed with the left hook. He has shown in the past that he takes a good punch. You don't want to take too many from Tyson.
But now look,
nothing wrong, man. Come on.
This guy will slow down.
Second shot.
Now just weather the storm for another round. You understand?
Come on,
you're
talking
to him.
You didn't do much more than you did.
So Kevin Rooney wants Mike Tyson to jab a little bit more. Biggs starts the third round backing up a little bit.
Good stiff jab on Mike Tyson. Tyson will constantly apply pressure to Biggs. Keep working his body and working the jab like Kevin Rooney stated. People don't realize this, and I learned this from Angelo Dundee. It's not a matter how long your jab is, the fact that if you have a jab, use it. That offsets someone else's jab.
Another left hook.
The hook's gonna land all night, Barry, because his right hand is down. Let me show you what Tyson does when he delivers that left hook. He takes one, two steps in, dips, and puts his whole body, all his weight behind the punch. A lot of leverage. One, two. You see it. Steps in. So you have to time it. You have to time his movement. One, two. Again, same thing. One, two. And he throws it.
That was a little short left hand that did get in. Shot with the left hand. And now the cut over the left eye, and it's pretty bad.
It's the same eye, the same cut.
And another big left hand, and Biggs is hurt. Now he gets out of there. A lot of blood from the left eye of Tyrell Biggs.
That's the same thing that probably happened with David Bates. They're toe-to-toe. It's a terrible mistake.
Something you pointed out before the fight. And now it's Tyson just hammering him.
That's a nasty cut. It's the blood is seeping to the eye. It's going to require a lot of work in the corner of Tyrell Biggs to stop that bleeding.
The cut is right above the eye. It's exactly in the same place as the last one.
Biggs, I don't know what happened. All that gym work has gone down the drain because he's not boxing, not using his tools. He's trying to out-muscle Mike Tyson, which is not his fight plan.
And there's a huge left hand.
Break! I'll punch you. Let me go.
They may stop it. That's a nasty cut.
And don't think I want to tell you what a finisher Mike Tyson is. The pressure, the relentless pressure of Tyson takes its toll.
It's a big man.
There you see that cut against that he absorbed against Tyrell, against David Bay, and here it is right now being worked on. That was a 32 stitch gash that he suffered from Bay.
Now you see how your gas is coming. You see.
Now let's see if we can catch it as it happens. That's the punch that apparently sliced Bay open. Excuse me, Tyrell Biggs open.
It's the same right hand, Larry, that was thrown by David Bay.
Let's remember that Biggs has fought his best when he's been in trouble.
But I think it's fair to say that he's not in there against David Bay tonight. Right hand body shot and the left hand behind it by Tyson.
Mike Tyson is not just loading up one punch. He's trying to put his punches together. He's trying to put together combinations. A mistake he made with Tony Tucker.
Tyson, Ray, to me, seems to be a little bit more patient tonight.
Yes, in fact, he is a little more composed, picking his shots. But again, I don't know why they don't pick it up in Biggs' corner, the way Tyson steps in and leaves his chin so vulnerable. The way I see it now, Mike Tyson has made Biggs fight his fight.
So far, the cut has not been any worse. And remember, it was a pretty good job done by Ace Morales, cut man, in the fight with David Bay. But again, Tyson just putting all the pressure on him, having it his way.
Didn't seem like Mike was a good short uppercut by Mike Tyson. A little more body movement from Tyrell Biggs now. Start throwing some uppercuts.
He took a big left hand there. And another.
The cut is reopened again.
Wait, get that. One go. Get back.
How does it happen, Ray, that a fighter like Biggs in this case tonight will go into a fight with a game plan and almost from the opening bell he'll just let that game plan go away?
It's all concentration. You got to stick to something that's working for you. And what I see in Tyson stick to his game plan. He works the body with that right hand. He drills a hard right hand to the body and comes up with a good left hook.
But Biggs is doing almost everything exactly the opposite of what he said he was going to do. Huge left hand there by Tyson. And a combination by Tyson, a left and a right behind him.
Let him go.
Getting to be a mismatch.
Right now, Tyson looks like he's rolling in like the tide from the Atlantic Ocean a few steps from Convention Hall.
You had it good, Doc. Don't worry. We're going to be all right.
No problem. In that bottle. Bob. Yeah, no problem.
The brain doctor is taking a look.
I got it. All set.
But the cut appears no worse than it did
earlier. Put your head back. Back. All the way back.
Desperate, and you're laying back and taking it easy. You can't take it easy with this guy. You gotta keep the pressure on this guy. You gotta move your hand. All you gotta do is throw the combination. You gotta put 2, 3, 4 punches together. You understand me? You understand what I'm saying?
He won't be there. You just be a little bit something.
He's not going to be there. One more round.
Let's go.
And you will not charge or not nothing.
One more round. He's not there, baby.
Come on, seconds out.
And so we start the fifth round, and Tyson is right on his man. Kevin Rudy exhorting him to throw two or three punch combinations. A little swelling under the right eye of Tyrell Biggs as well right now. Tyrell's going to recognize himself when he wakes up tomorrow morning.
I don't know what that was a second ago by Tyrell Biggs. This is somewhat disappointing for Biggs' corner because he has more talent than what he's showing tonight. The left hooks has been consistent and very, very accurate with Mike Tyson.
But they're there for a good reason, right?
Well, Tyson, because look what you have in front of you. The fact that Biggs is not doing what he worked on. He just forgot about his game plan. Totally abandoned it. Mike Tyson, he's doing what he does best. Worked the body, worked the head.
Simple fact is, and I don't think you have to be a boxing expert, Tyrell Biggs is dropping his right hand and he's just leaving himself completely open for the left hook.
Well, I think this is a good education for the public because the fans at home, because they're seeing what should not be done against a fighter like a Mike Tyson or any boxer or puncher, rather, in particular. You have to be consistent, keep those hands out.
And again, that cut over the left eye has opened up. There is a swelling under the right eye that has a lot of blood right below the surface of the skin also.
What Biggs has to do, he has to work something out, which is actually the left jab to break that rhythm and stop the momentum of Mike Tyson. He continues, Barry, to allow Mike to dominate.
And again, bleeding from the mouth as he has been since the first round. Not a pretty sight.
He subjects himself, Biggs does, to standing toe-to-toe and being actually a punching bag. This way, you'll probably see more knots and bruises because Tyson is hard. Good body shot by Mike Tyson.
And remember, the doctor was in Tyrell Biggs' corner and looked long and hard at that cut in the last round, and you're going to see him again. Tyson hit on a break that time.
When I say break, you both break, understood? You understand, Mike, Joe? Let's go.
That cut looks even uglier. I'm
Friday,
sure the doctor will look at it.
Bloody Friday.
You're not doing enough.
He's turning around. Now look, don't get into this shit.
I can't punch. Can't do nothing out there.
Now listen. No. All right, but look.
Hey. No, you got to break clean, man. Tell him.
And keep your hands up when this guy's. Don't trust the guy. Now look.
Keep your head.
Are you all right?
Harold Letterman, unofficial. How do you score the fight?
Well, Larry, I've got a 49-46 Mike Tyson, 4-1 in rounds. Based on the 4 points that we score, it's very simple to score. Mike Tyson's just been the effective aggressor, the harder hitter, and he's dominating at this point.
This guy's dying.
Okay.
You understand? But don't let the guy see you.
Come on, this guy's hurt.
Lou Duva is doing everything possible to inspire Biggs. He said as he left the ring, you heard him, you heard him.
Get back, please. Get back.
That is wishful thinking.
It's over the set. All right, break. Come on, step back. Step back, please. Help. Step back. I'll take the point away.
And Biggs holding on a great deal now. There was a right hand by Tyson. And another.
Biggs, you have to say, he takes a good shot, but it this was not necessary. I mean, I figured that Biggs would use that height, that reach, and his ring generalship to make this fight a little easier for him. Instead, he abandoned his tactics, his strategy he worked on in the gym, and select to fight Mike Tyson's fight. I love those body shots, though. It weakens the fighter. It takes away his legs, so you won't see that much movement from Tyrell Biggs. And what Mike wants him to be is a stationary target.
Tyson has fought an excellent fight so far. I admit that Biggs has let him fight an excellent fight, but Tyson's been very sharp.
Well, I like Tyson because now he's putting his combinations together. He's not loading up anymore.
And he's also showing a lot more patience. He was a guy who would just get in there and go for the quick kill and try to do it, generally speaking, with one punch.
You know what's happening here? Actually, Biggs is just wearing down slowly but surely. Slowly but surely. It's like chopping a tree down. It's the same principle. He's wearing, Mike Tyson's wearing his man down. And the way you can tell this, Burr, is the fact you notice this very, very seldom does Biggs retaliate. Very seldom you see Biggs come back with a combination of his own.
Break! No punches, let him out. Let him out, Joe. Let him go, come on, Joe. Let him go and take the point away now.
These two, of course, go back a long way, all the way back to amateur days. Now the left hand, and there's a great shot. Biggs is in trouble.
Yeah. The way it looks now, Biggs like a defeated warrior now. He's been pounded on for five rounds. And he's slowly but surely wearing down. His legs don't look steady. Tyson's getting stronger.
And Biggs is just holding on.
Made the betters happy, if nothing else, because Tyrell Biggs has lasted six rounds. They say that Tyson is predictable, but so is a hurricane. What can you do about it?
Well, here's something he hasn't been predictable the last couple of weeks because of the football strike, but Inside the NFL will now be back because the strike has been, and I'll put it in quotes, settled. Your hosts, Len Dawson and Nick Bonacani. It's right here on HBO Thursdays at 11.
More sevens. That six is beautiful. Let's see, 6-5-1, 6-5-2-1. Get to the side, play with this guy now, you understand? Yes. This guy's got nothing. Give him the feint, like you did before. Give him the feint. Step to the side, fight.
You're taking the best of these guys, so what the hell's wrong with you? Fire back.
Come on, this guy's gone.
Now listen,
come
to
on, you're better fighting him.
Fire from your chin, though. The guy can't fight inside, so if you got no legs, fight him inside if you got
Those numbers you heard were a fight combination. Customato, the mentor of Mike Tyson, used to put numbers on the different fight combinations, and Kevin Rooney is Tyson's disciple.
I heard something interesting in Big's corner. His trainer said, if your legs are gone, stand and fight them. Stand toe-to-toe and fight them. So apparently the legs of Tyra Biggs are shot because you don't see movement.
He hasn't had movement, actually, for past two or three rounds. And just to further that point, in the last round, our punch stat figures, Tyrell Biggs threw 15 punches, Ray.
Again, like I said earlier, Barry, he's just wearing down. You can appreciate, especially from ringside, those body attacks by Mike Tyson. I mean, he gets his whole body, a lot of leverage. I am surprised that I have not seen that many uppercuts from Tyrell Biggs.
Now that was his game plan. I mean, that was something he said he had to do.
All right, break, no punches.
Get back, cool. Let him go, Charles. Get back. Good.
A cut, incidentally, at least for the last couple of rounds, has not shown any more blood.
It appears to me that Biggs is trying to time Tyson with the counter right. I notice when Tyson comes in, Biggs tried to stand his ground and throw a right hand. So now that tells me that Biggs is pretty much falling into the same trap as Mike Tyson, trying for one punch.
And he's never, there's a right hand that just caught Biggs off balance.
Biggs is covering up a lot of times unnecessarily and just trying to protect himself.
Biggs, of course, has never been known as a guy who could put a man away with one punch. He dropped Snipes with a good right hand. But he didn't put him away.
The elbow there from Tyson. Cabarroni was telling Tyson, get a couple head fights. Oh, that punch.
That was a tremendous left hand.
This is it.
He is gone right now. He has no legs at all. And 10 seconds to go in a round. There's a left hand. He's down again. It's over. It's all over. And it wasn't even close.
And what we've seen has happened so often, in which a fighter after a few rounds starts to hang on to Tyson, that we have to say it's Tyson's credit. He's the one who makes it happen. He makes it happen with his pressure, and no matter what an opponent's plan is, that plan disintegrates like a broken piece of crockery when it's faced with that kind of pressure. There's no way to practice to that. I pointed out in the past, it's like trying to, how do you practice to hit Nolan Ryan's fastball or Boris Becker's serve? Where do you get the practice for that?
You don't. It's that simple. Let's take a look at the first knockdown. It was a left hand and a big one, and I feel like I'm being redundant with that, but he hit him with many big left hands, Ray.
Well, look at the right hand of Tyrell Biggs. It's down, and the left hook has been landing from round one. But the first minute or two of round one, Biggs was doing his job, boxing. Now he becomes a stationary target. That toe-to-toe tactics proved wrong against David Bay, which he subsequently was cut. And now the same thing happens. So all we had was actually a replay of what took place. Here, Mike Tyson just wears his man down with beautiful short left hooks.
It was really more his legs than anything else. He was just kind of off balance, had his legs together, just never really got it together. Here's the final knockdown now.
No, I think it's the power and the fact that Mike Tyson actually wore his man down.
One more look at the end for Tyrell Biggs.
And Bob, let me say this for you and Lark. There is a way to stop a guy coming in, and it's with a jab. You gotta work on jabs, angles, and combinations.
Yeah, and Ray, he did it for one round. That was it.
But that was his fault, bro. He forgot. He just gave up. We just abandoned the tactics that would have been effective.
Now, that's what I mean. As a matter of fact, and I don't mean to just blow smoke at you because you did it, but you were the only person I've ever seen start with a fight plan and stay with a fight plan and just not get away from it.
Well, that's what is required against a guy with the kind of heart, determination, power of Mike Tyson. You've got to be consistent.
Let's get the official decision now from Michael Buffer. Mike?
Ladies and gentlemen, the end comes at 2 minutes, 59 seconds of the seventh round. The winner, still the undefeated, undisputed heavyweight champion of the world, Mike Tyson!
All right, right now, Larry Merchant trying to make his way over to the champion, and I believe he is. Let's go to Larry right now with Mike Tyson. Larry?
And I'm with Mike Tyson, who first administered a paint job and then sort of wrecked the whole house. Mike, he looked very impressive in the first round, looking like Ali the way he moved and jabbed. What were your thoughts at that point, and then how did you attack him to stop that?
Well, in my mind, I knew this was 15 rounds, and I was prepared to put the pressure on constantly for 15 rounds. You know, I was having a great time in there. I felt good. I was in the best condition of my life, and I did what I was supposed to do.
Well, tell me, what did you think in that first round when he was moving, trying to do an Ali with his left?
I knew when I came in this fight, I was the best fighter in the world, and not a man alive that can beat me.
What broke him down? Was it just
constantly body punches? When I was hitting him with body punches, and I heard him, actually, he was crying in there. making woman gestures like, I can't find him, but I knew that he was breaking down soon.
You're saying that Biggs was crying when you hit him?
Yes.
When did that happen?
And perhaps the fourth round on.
So that you knew you had him by that
Absolutely,
time?
Absolutely, but I knew he was toughing it, taking those punches.
Was this your most satisfying fight in the sense of the way you went about it patiently and businesslike, not getting excited, not trying to take him out with one punch?
Well, I was very calm, and I was thinking about Roberto Duran, how he used to cut down the runners and just wear them down, and I had that frame of mind when I was in the ring.
All right, Mike, let's take a look at the first knockdown, and would you describe what was happening?
Well, I was in there looking for the punch, boom, and I knew it would come, because when he threw a punch, his hand opened a little, and I thought I could slip a punch right in there.
Were you trying to work on his cut early on because he was pretty bloody?
No, I wasn't even thinking about the cut. I was just hitting to the body, softening him up.
So that from then on, you really feel that it was inevitable after the first few
Absolutely.
Rounds?
Absolutely.
All right, Mike, we hear now that you're going to fight Larry Holmes next. Why Larry Holmes?
Well, I don't have any faith on the matter. I was just a fighter, and I'll defend my title against any man in the world. If I was you, I'd talk to Jim Jacobs about that.
Do you want to fight Larry Holmes?
I'll fight any man in the world because I believe there's no one in this planet that can beat me.
Okay, then let me ask Jimmy Jacobs, the co-manager, Mike, why do you want to fight Larry Holmes next?
Well, the reason is that I would say that 90% of the world thought that Larry Holmes beat Michael Spinks the last time they fought. In fact, Larry, of 46 newspaper men polled after the fight, 42 men of the 46 voted for Larry Holmes in the last fight with Michael Spinks. Larry is sitting at home feeling that he's the champion, and that's the reason we're going to fight him.
But he did lose his last two fights. He hasn't fought in a good long while. A lot of people are saying, what is this, some kind of an antique show? Or is this in the best or worst traditions of boxing, fighting these kinds of fights?
I don't think it's either in the worst or best traditions of boxing. Boxing history is replete with 27 heavyweight champions attempting to regain the title. However, the champion we're talking about, Larry Holmes, was defeated by a split decision in his last fight against Michael Spinks, where everyone, even you, Larry, everyone, including you, thought that Larry Holmes won the fight.
Okay, then what about Michael Spinks? That is the most attractive fight out there, according to everyone, and you can jump in here too, Bill Caton. What about Michael Spinks, and why aren't you going to take him on next or right after next or whenever?
Whenever we're ready to, we make our plans for that. We haven't made our plans to take on Michael Spinks because a fight with Michael Spinks, which is a pay-per-view, closed-circuit fight, takes a minimum of 5 months, during which time Mike would not fight. Mike wants to fight more frequently.
So you're saying now you will fight Michael Spinks eventually?
I would say this, that Michael Spinks is definitely in our future. Definitely in our future, but not in our immediate future.
Let me put it this way. If you have been saying that you have a lot of fights planned, that you have told various people you're going to fight their man, What about going in there and saying, we'll fight you winner take all, or winner take almost all? We'll give $1 million to the loser and $20 million to the winner. Would you fight Spinks under those circumstances?
Under the circumstances, if he would take $1 million,
Or you take a million.
Yes, we would fight Michael Spinks on the basis that the loser takes $1 million and the winner take the rest. Yes, we would do that.
That's one way of making the deal.
Yeah, that would be one way of making the deal quick.
You sound pretty confident. And let's see what Barry and Ray think about that one.
By Tyson. Teofilo Stevenson, and I admit it was 5 years ago, but he really bothered
there
me.
There is the hook, again, because his hands are down. He's moving right, but he keeps his hands down too low. Tyson has very quick hands for a big man.
Stevenson beat Biggs by going to the body. Broke three ribs, as a matter of fact. A lot of water under the bridge since then. They're going to have to fix Tyson's equipment here in just a moment as it has come loose.
Biggs is starting to become a stationary target, which is wrong.
Right hand by Tyson. A little bit of blood inside the mouth of Tyrell Biggs.
I don't know if Biggs can fight a perfect fight, but he fought about as perfect a round as he could have hoped for to start this fight.
things are no good.
See our punch stat, which tells you that Tyson is not effective with the jab, and of course Tyrell Biggs is very effective with it.
Let it pull you around. Let it pull you around with two or three. Then stop. Yeah.
And as Punchstat showed, or confirmed, that was a very good round using the left hand as well as he can. That is exactly what Biggs must do to stay in this fight. Can Tyson neutralize the jab?
See, Biggs was doing great the first 2 minutes of the first round, keeping that jab consistent, moving lateral, giving angles. But then the last maybe 45 seconds of the round, Barry, he stopped, became stationary target. The hands again, which I think is a major mistake because of Tyson's hand speed. And Tyson throws his punch. He loops his right hand. He loops his hook. And Biggs could be asked for a few problems.
And the thing that strikes me, actually, is Biggs did have a round and did fight according to his fight plan, but he still took some strong shots from Tyson.
You see, now Biggs, again, is starting to stand there and exchange toe-to-toe, like I said earlier. You can't do that. Tyson's punches come so fast with so much velocity behind them. It's devastating.
Biggs has shown a tendency, actually, throughout his career, and especially later in his career, most recently, to get in there occasionally and want to slug it out when he's been stunned. And that could be suicide.
And the way that Biggs is moving to his right, that's wrong because of the hook of Mike Tyson. He'll run right to the left hook.
Two hands, punch your eyes. Let him go. Come on. Hey, Frank!
What I was expecting from Biggs, and in fact, he told me this, that he's been working this in the gym, was the uppercuts, the jab, to go through Tyson's defense. I have not seen that yet.
And the game plan was for Biggs, rather, to move to his left. Now, he's been moving to his right, and as you said, he's been getting himself a little trouble when he does so.
Tyson's driven some tremendous shots to the body, and that's going to help bring those hands down even lower.
Remember, Stevenson broke three ribs of Tyrell Biggs.
I'm looking for a left hook, Barry. I really am, because look at the right hand of Tyrell Biggs. That's the uppercut, but you got to come back with the right hand. The uppercut raises the chin of a guy who crouches in, and the right hand does most damage.
There was a big right hand, best punch of the fight.
That was the left hook, Barry. That was the left hook I was talking about. Now, if Biggs should make it back to his corner, I'm sure Georgie Bennett will say, keep those hands high.
Right, left. I'll get it right.
Right, left, Jeff. But the fact of the matter is, the right hand's down, Biggs, the left hook has been scoring. And it rocked Biggs.
As Michael Tyson said before this fight, everybody has a plan until they're hit.
A little bit more coming in, a little bit more jab. He started that run real good, then he slowed down with the jab. And it hurt him with that hook. You understand me? I want you to 5-1 now. Seven coming in. What's going to go 5-1? 5-5-1. You understand me? Take a little spring back and put a little twist in there. Take a little twist.
And here is Tyson's most effective punch. Biggs has been on his flat-footed more in this round than he was in the first round. Got nailed with the left hook. He has shown in the past that he takes a good punch. You don't want to take too many from Tyson.
But now look.
Nothing wrong, man. Come on.
This guy will slow down.
Second shot.
Now just, whether the storm for another round.
Second shot.
You understand?
Come on.
You got your...
There's too much more to
second
do.
Second
shot. So Kevin Rooney wants Mike Tyson to jab a little bit more. And
Biggs starts the third round backing up a little bit.
Good stiff jab by Mike Tyson. Tyson will constantly apply pressure to Biggs. Keep working his body and working a jab like Kevin Rooney stated. People don't realize this, and I learned this from Angelo Dundee. It's not a matter how long your jab is, the fact that you have a jab to make this fight a little easier for him. Instead, he abandoned his tactics, his strategy he worked on in the gym, and select to fight Mike Tyson's fight. I love those body shots, Doug. It weakens the fighter, it takes away his legs, so you won't see that much movement from Tyrell Biggs. And what Mike wants him to be is a stationary target.
Tyson has fought an excellent fight so far. I admit that Biggs has let him fight an excellent fight, but Tyson's been very sharp.
Well, I like Tyson because now he's putting his combinations together. He's not loading up anymore.
And he's also showing a lot more patience. He was a guy who would just get in there and go for the quick kill and try to do it, generally speaking, with one punch.
You know what's happening here? Actually, Biggs is just wearing down slowly but surely. Slowly but surely. It's like chopping a tree down. It's the same principle. He's wearing, Mike Tyson's wearing his man down. And the way you can tell this, Barry, is the fact you notice this very, very seldom does Biggs retaliate. Very seldom you see Biggs come back with a combination of his own.
Break! No punches, let him out. Let him out, Joe. Let him go, come on, Joe. Let him go and take the point away now. Get back.
These two, of course, go back a long way, all the way back to amateur days. Now the left hand, and there's a great shot. Biggs is in trouble.
Yeah. Break. The way it looks now, Biggs like a defeated warrior now. He's been pounded on for five rounds.
Break, let him go.
And he's slowly but surely wearing down. His legs don't look steady. Tyson's getting stronger.
And Biggs is just holding on.
Well, that made the bettors happy, if nothing else, because Tyrell Biggs has lasted six rounds. They say that Tyson is predictable, but so is a hurricane. What can you do about it?
Well, here's something he hasn't been predictable the last couple of weeks because of the football strike, but Inside the NFL will now be back because the strike has been, and I'll put it in quotes, settled. Your hosts, Len Dawson and Nick Bonacani. It's right here on HBO Thursdays at 11.
More sevens, like the game. More sevens, more sevens. That six is beautiful. Let's see, 6-5-1, 6-5-2-1. Get to the side. Play with this guy now. You understand me? Yes. This guy's got nothing. Give him the feint, like you did before. Give him the feint. Give him a feint. Step to the side. Fight.
You're taking the best he's got. So what the hell's wrong with you? Fire back.
Come on, this guy's gone.
Now listen,
come
to
on, you're better fighting him.
Fire from your chin, though. The guy can't fight inside. So if you got no legs, fight him inside. If you got.
Those numbers you heard were a fight combination. Customato, the mentor of Mike Tyson, used to put numbers on the different fight combinations, and Kevin Rooney is Tyson's disciple.
I heard something interesting in Biggs' corner. His trainer said, if your legs are gone, stand and fight him. Stand toe-to-toe and fight him. So apparently the legs of Tyrell Biggs are shot because you don't see movement.
He hasn't had movement actually for past two or three rounds. And just to further that point, in the last round, our punch stat figures, Tyrell Biggs threw 15 punches, Ray.
Again, like I said earlier, Barry, he's just wearing down. You can appreciate, especially from ringside, those body attacks by Mike Tyson. I mean, he gets his whole body, a lot of leverage. I am surprised that I have not seen that many uppercuts from Tyrell Biggs.
That was his game plan. I mean, that was something he said he had to do.
No punches. Get back to him. Let him go, Charlie. Let him go. Get back. Good.
A cut, incidentally, at least for the last couple of rounds, has not shown any more blood.
it appears to me that Biggs was trying to time Tyson with the counter right. I noticed when Tyson comes in, Biggs tried to stand his ground and throw a right hand. So now that tells me that Biggs is pretty much falling through the same trap as Mike Tyson, trying for one punch.
And he's never, there's a right hand that just caught Biggs off balance.
Biggs is covering up a lot of times unnecessarily and just trying to protect himself.
Biggs, of course, has never been known as a guy who could put a man away with one punch. He dropped Snipes with a good right hand. But he didn't put him away.
The elbow there from Tyson. Cabarroni was telling Tyson, get a couple head fights. Oh, that punch.
That was a tremendous left hand.
This is it.
He is gone right now. He has no legs at all. And 10 seconds to go in a round. There's a left hand. He's down again. It's over. It's all over. And it wasn't even close.
And use it. That offsets someone else's jab.
Another left hook.
The hook's going to land all night, Barry, because his right hand is down. Let me show you what Tyson does when he delivers that left hook. He takes one, two steps in, dips, and puts his whole body, all his weight behind the punch. A lot of leverage. One, two. You see it. Steps in. So you have to time it. You have to time his movement. One, two. Again, same thing. One, two. And he throws it.
That was a little short left hand that did get in. Shot with the left hand. And now the cut over the left eye, and it's pretty bad.
It's the same eye, the same cut.
And another big left hand, and Biggs is hurt. Now he gets out of there. A lot of blood from the left eye of Tyrell Biggs.
That's the same thing that probably happened with David Bates. They're toe-to-toe. It's a terrible mistake.
Something you pointed out before the fight. And now it's Tyson just hammering him.
That's a nasty cut. It's the blood is seeping to the eye. This would require a lot of work in the corner of Tyrell Biggs to stop that bleeding.
The cut is right above the eye. It's exactly in the same place as the last one.
Biggs, I don't know what happened. All that gym work has gone down the drain because he's not boxing, not using his tools. He's trying to out-muscle Mike Tyson, which is not his fight plan.
And there's a huge left hand.
Break! I'll punch you. Let me go.
They may stop it. That's a nasty cut.
I don't think I can tell you what a finisher Mike Tyson is. The pressure, the relentless pressure of Tyson takes its toll.
That's a big man.
Hold it there.
And don't put it in the limit.
There you see that cut. Against and that he absorbed against Tyrell, against David Bay, and here it is right now being worked on. That was a 32 stitch gash that he suffered from Bay.
Now you see how your gas is coming. You see.
Now let's see if we can catch it as it happens. That's the punch that apparently sliced Bay open. Excuse me, Tyrell. Biggs open.
Come on, give me something to drink.
It's the same right hand, Larry, that was thrown by David Biggs.
Let's remember that Biggs has fought his best when he's been in trouble.
But I think it's fair to say that he's not in there against David Bay tonight. Right hand body shot and the left hand behind it by Tyson. Mike Tyson is not just loading up with one punch. He's trying to put his punches together. He's trying to put together combinations. A mistake he made with Tony Tucker. Tyson Ray, to me, seems to be a little bit more patient tonight. Yes, in fact, he is a little more composed, picking his shots. But again, I don't know why they don't pick it up in Biggs' corner, the way Tyson steps in and leaves his chin so vulnerable. The way I see it now, Mike Tyson has made Biggs fight his fight. So far, the cut has not been any worse. And remember, it was a pretty good job done by Ace Morales, cut man, in the fight with David Bay. But again, Tyson just putting all the pressure on him, having it his way. Didn't seem like much. It was a good short uppercut by Mike Tyson. A little more body movement from Tyrell Biggs now. Start throwing some uppercuts.
He took a big left hand there. And another.
The cut is reopened again.
Wait, get back. Let him go. Get back.
How does it happen, Ray, that a fighter like Biggs in this case tonight will go into a fight with a game plan and almost from the opening bell he'll just let that game plan go away?
It's all concentration. You got to stick to something that's working for you. And what I see in Tyson stick to his game plan. He works the body with that right hand. He drills a hard right hand to the body and comes up with a good left hook.
But Biggs is doing almost everything exactly the opposite of what he said he was going to do. And that is Mike Tyson making Tyrell Biggs wait, and both fighters making the crowd wait. And they're starting to get the first glimpse now of Mike Tyson. And Tyson, we understand, is going to run into the ring. And here comes Mike Tyson now. And as usual, he is all business, draped in the three belts that he now owns.
Well, as Mills Lane, the referee from Nevada, says, Mike Tyson surely looks like he's saying, let's get it on.
He was telling us the other day that there's an expression on the streets where he was raised that say, you got to bring it to get it. And that's exactly his philosophy.
It means that you can't win at the tables with your hands in your pockets. And you can't win in here unless you take some shots, take some risks.
You know, he quotes Joe Frazier, actually, as he comes into the ring when people criticize his height, that he's too small, and he says Frazier believed he was big enough to get the job done, and that's all that counts. Mike Tyson, of course, 31-0, 27 knockouts.
Until he won the title, actually, he hadn't fought anybody more impressive than Biggs has fought to this point. Since that time, Tyson has fought a better class of fighter than Biggs has.
And the crowd, again, still very much into this. 5 years difference. Mike Tyson is younger than Biggs, even though he's had 31 fights to Biggs' 15.
Yeah, Barry, and Tyson, interestingly, came in a few pounds less than he has recently. Obviously, he wants to be able to keep up with the guy who's the boxer. And Biggs came in bulked up by a few pounds. Obviously, he wants to be strong for Tyson. What it means is they're both ready.
15 rounds for the undisputed heavyweight championship of the world. A referee for this bout is Tony Orlando. Introducing first, fighting out of the blue corner. He's wearing the white trunks and weighs 228¾ pounds. He's from Philadelphia, Pennsylvania. This Olympic gold medal champion has 15 consecutive victories, 10 by knockout. Introducing the number one challenger in the world, Tyrell Biggs. Fighting out of the red corner, wearing the solid black trunks, he weighs 216 pounds. From Catskill, New York, 27 of his 31 unblemished victories are by knockout. Ladies and gentlemen, the undefeated, undisputed, heavyweight champion of the world, Iron Mike Tyson!
Gentlemen, you received your instructions prior to coming to the ring. Therefore, I expect a good, clean bout. Do you have any questions? Touch gloves, back to you, corner. Good luck.
Barry and Ray, I wouldn't be surprised if this fight lasted a minute or an hour.
I feel exactly the same way. It's one of those fights you really don't know. I believe in the opinions of many of the people who feel that Tyrell Biggs can win the fight. I don't happen to be of that school, but you just don't know.
Expect Tyson to jump right on Tyrell Biggs.
Three questions that Mike Tyson really has to answer. Can he cope with a clever boxer? Can he survive a heavy puncher? And can he persevere when he's hurt?
You notice right from the start, Tyson is applying the pressure, trying to slow his man down. I'm seeing more jabs from Mike Tyson than I've seen in the past. I see a lot of movement on the part of Tyrell Biggs. Good lateral movement. Those hands should be up a little higher because, again, the hand speed of Mike Tyson is very good.
You have said that Biggs has to go side to side to win the fight, Ray.
Go side to side. Give your man angles. Throw the jab like he's doing now, not to let Tyson set up.
Now, Tyson also said that he has found a pattern in Tyrell Biggs that he feints to the right before the punch actually is thrown.
Well, whatever he does, the fact that Tyson has to set up to get that kind of leverage. See, a good snapping jab is very effective. Whether or not Biggs can keep this up is yet to be seen. It's not time to be pretty in here, it's just time to frustrate this man. And that's what they want from our Biggs. Good, consistent jab.
And along the lines of patterns, Biggs feels that Tyson actually bobs in a pattern four times, and then he comes up with his head.
See, wait, now here, you saw how Tyson walks in with that crouching style to deliver a shot. He's trying for the head. Now we see him head hunting from Mike Tyson. He can't get into that.
Good shot by Tyson.
Get off the ropes, tie your man up. That's the way. Get him back into the center ring. Use the jab again. And come with that right hand.
That was a quick little overhand right by Tyrell Biggs.
Biggs now is talking to Tyson. Again, Barry's trying to frustrate him. But I don't like his hands down that low. I don't like Biggs' hands down so low. Because Tyson throws those looping right hands and left hooks.
Keep him up, Mike. Keep him up.
Body shot. Huge left hand there by Tyson. By Tyson, a left and a right behind him.
All right, Frank, look back. Let him go.
Getting to be a mismatch.
Right now, Tyson looks like he's rolling in like the tide from the Atlantic Ocean a few steps from Convention Hall.
You had it good, Doc. We're going to be all right.
No problem.
Ray doctor is taking a look.
I got it all set.
But the cut appears no worse than it did.
Put your head back. Back, all the way back.
And you're laying back. You're taking it easy. You can't take it easy with this guy. You gotta keep the pressure on this guy. You gotta move your hand. All you gotta do is throw the combination. You gotta put two, three, four punches together.
Understand me? Yes. You understand what I'm saying?
He won't be there if he's still in with something.
He's not going to be there. One more round.
Let's go.
And you will not charge or not nothing.
One more round. He's not there, baby.
Come on, second down.
And so we start the fifth round, and Tyson is right on his man. Kevin Rudy exhorting him to throw two and three punch combinations. A little swelling under the right eye of Tyrell Diggs as well right now. Tyrell's going to recognize himself when he wakes up tomorrow morning. I don't know what that was a second ago by Tyrell Biggs. This is somewhat disappointing for Biggs' corner because he has more talent than what he's showing tonight. The left hooks has been consistent and very, very accurate with Mike Tyson.
But they're there for a good reason, right?
Well, Tyson, because look what you have in front of you. The fact that Biggs is not doing what he worked on. He just forgot about his game plan. Totally abandoned it. Mike Tyson, he's doing what he does best. Worked the body, worked the head.
Simple fact is, and I don't think you have to be a boxing expert, Tyrell Biggs is dropping his right hand and he's just leaving himself completely open for the left hook.
Well, I think this is a good education for the public because the fans at home, because they're seeing what should not be done against a fighter like a Mike Tyson or any boxer or puncher, rather, in particular. You have to be consistent, keep those hands high.
And again, that cut over the left eye has opened up. There is a swelling under the right eye that has a lot of blood right below the surface of the skin also.
What Biggs has to do, he has to work something out, which is actually the left jab to break that rhythm and stop the momentum of Mike Tyson. He continues, Barry, to allow Mike to dominate.
And again, bleeding from the mouth as he has been since the first round. Not a pretty sight.
He subjects himself, Biggs does, to standing toe-to-toe and being actually a punching bag. This way, this probably see more knots and bruises because Tyson is hard. Good body shot by Mike Tyson.
And remember, the doctor was in Tyrell Biggs' corner and looked long and hard at that cut in the last round, and you're going to see him again. Tyson hit on a break that time.
I'm telling you, it's a boxing match, man, a wrestling match. And I say break, you both break, understood? You understand, Mike, Joe? Let's go.
That cut looks even uglier. I'm
Bloody,
sure the doctor will look at it.
Bloody Friday.
You're not doing enough.
He's better than others. The guy's
down.
Now, look, don't get into this shit.
I can't punch. Can't do nothing out there.
Now, listen.
No.
All right, but look.
Hey. No, you got to break clean, man. Listen, tell him.
And keep your hands up when this guy's. Don't trust the guy. Now look.
Keep your head.
Are you all right?
Harold Letterman, unofficial official. How do you score the fight?
Well, Larry, I've got it 49-46. Mike Tyson, 4-1 in rounds. Based on the 4 points that we score, it's very simple to score. Mike Tyson's just been the effective aggressor, the harder hitter, and he's dominating at this point.
This guy's dying.
You understand? But don't let the guy see you.
Come on, this guy's hurt.
Lou Duva is doing everything possible to inspire Biggs. He said as he left the ring, you heard him, you heard him.
Get back, please. Get back.
That is wishful thinking.
It's over the set. All right, break. Come on, step back. Step back, please. Help. Step back. I'll take the corner away.
And Biggs holding on a great deal now. There was a right hand by Tyson. And another.
Biggs, you have to say, he takes a good shot, but it
This was not necessary. I mean, I figured that Biggs would use that height, that reach, and his ring generalship